What's up, people? Doing the cyber, Homo sapiens on the intertubes? What's going on? What's popping? To quote Del the Funky Homo Sapien, my favorite rapper, if you flow off beat and it's on purpose, you better flow back on beat or the effort is worthless. What does this have to do with studio practice? This is episode 31, but in episode 30... I took a slightly more conceptual approach to the video series by outlining my ADSR method for the evaluation of works of contemporary art and design. That video was slightly heavier than this video, and again, I like to flow off beat. So in this episode, what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at the design, prototyping, and manufacture of a robotic pneumatic drum kit that I used in a series of performance pieces, the first of which was at Detroit's Music Hall. Hopefully you'll enjoy this video. Also, I want to say a special hello to the raft of new subscribers that I got this week. So hello, and welcome to the series. Existence. This is the stick mechanism on the snare drum number one. You can see that this is a piezoelectric disc which sends MIDI signals and audio signals back to the computer. There were two kits, stage left and stage right, in that white rectangle. You can see that they hung over the stage. I constructed and manufactured these before I was an accomplished CNC machinist, so take a look at how loosely constructed these objects, these machines, actually are. As I said, the kits were mounted stage left and stage right, and we had a human drummer as a third drummer. This box is a shock-mounted PIC microcontroller that I programmed to interpret MIDI messages. That's the power supply there. And here, the red rectangles in the upper left-hand corner are a series of relays that simply switch on and switch off the pneumatic, the compressed air that's going to these silver cylinders, these silver pistons. This is a public service announcement. Get off your ass and hey yo this is a public service announcement. Do you like this video series? Have you been watching it? And do you have interest potentially in studying in my studio, becoming a part of what we're putting together? You have until February 1st of this year to get an application in to the 2D department at Cranbrook Academy of Art. Look for the link below.